Hi everyone, so I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. So in this particular video, we'll be covering the topic of disputes in construction. The previous video, as you can see from the playlist of construction management, was dedicated to the claims in construction contracts. So you can check out that playlist for several other videos related to contracts, tenders, then management of contractors, subcontractors, JCRs, overheads, direct costs, planning, everything. Okay, so in this video, we'll be discussing about that what are disputes. What are the sources of disputes? This I'll be covering very briefly, just within 50 seconds or something like that. Then what are the dispute resolution methods along with the pros and cons of every method? This topic is extremely important, and if you want to become a contracts administrator, maybe at site or at head offices level, then you should know about these methods, especially about arbitration and litigation. Then see, these methods of mediation, conciliation and arbitration are called as alternate dispute resolution methods, ADR, because what they involve is they involve a dispute review board, DRB, which might consist of a single person also, or maybe a panel of members like three people, five people, but usually odd in number. Why odd, I'll tell you later in the video. So this board is chosen by the owner and contractor together, and this is also called as a third party board. Okay, so why is it called alternate dispute resolution? Because litigation usually takes place in the public forum, in usually courts and all, but these three methods, mediation, conciliation and arbitration, they although might be legally binding or no, that we'll discuss later only, but they are at least kept very confidential and they are not discussed in the public platforms. Okay, so that is why this is an alternate dispute resolution as compared to the litigation. Litigation is a direct formal method which involves the panel of judges and all, that usually crimes and all, no, if you would have seen in the movies also, if you would have faced, I don't expect anyone of you would have faced litigation, but definitely you would have seen in the movies and web series. So just moving on to the disputes, that what are disputes. See, disputes is nothing but, see what happens, they are just disagreements. I'll tell you one small example also. Disagreements or conflicts between two parties. Usually we are dealing with contractors versus client. Okay, so these two parties most probably are contractors versus client. Somewhere designers and contractors are also there, due to not agreeing to the claims. I'll take one example, and through that example I'll explain you what happens. Let's say one example, that the contractor is building one hospital project. Okay, so in erection of one column, RCC column, there is some quality defects. Okay, not very major quality defects, but the client claims that there is some quality defect. So client claims rework of column, and he tells that if you do not rework the column, because see, it's a minor defect, so might be possible that the contractor won't agree to this. So client says if you don't rework, then he will deduct 10 lakh rupees in the next running bill, and he will some other restriction also the client would have put, but we are just restricting that the client asks for rework as well as the deduction of 10 lakh rupees in the next RA bill. So this is a claim that the client has put on the contractor, but now the contractor says no, it's not at all something for which we might be required to do rework, like complete column should not be destroyed and made again. Instead, we'll do some finishing and all, so that the complete look of the column remains the same. But the client says no, it's some internal defect, he would have seen something. So he's telling no, I want the rework to happen. So since the client and contractor are not coming to a same page, so this can take the form of a dispute, because they are not settling for a certain consensus. Neither the client is agreeing nor the contractor is agreeing, so the work gets stopped and the matter can be taken to the third party. So this is called as a dispute. What was the claim here? Claim was just a kind of rework that the client has asked, and this particular thing is a claim. But it turns into dispute because the contractor is not agreeing to the claim put by the client. Okay. So what are the various reasons of these claims? What are the sources of disputes? This I just touch very briefly. See, the sources of disputes can be innumerable, like payment related. The payment might get delayed, like the client delayed the payment by certain time frame, or the client would have deducted some unreasonable amount from the RA bill. Okay, such things can happen, and might be the claim doesn't get settled at certain point of time, so it can take place of a dispute, take form of a dispute. Then scope variations, drawing variations, specification variations. Okay, then some delays from the contractor side, the client might put LD, but the contractor might not agree that it's not my complete fault that you put LD for the complete duration of extension. Okay, then some quality related issues might be there, which we discussed just now. Then weather related reasons might be there, because of which the contractor and client would not come to the same page. So all these reasons can be possible to give birth to any dispute in the construction project. We know the dynamicity of the construction projects, and we know how typical construction projects are, how unique they are, so we cannot predict from where the dispute might take form. Okay, so now moving on to the most important part of this video, which is nothing but the resolution methods of disputes. Okay, resolution of disputes. So the very first method of resolution, which is the most simplest one, is negotiation. So what is negotiation? Negotiation is nothing but what happens in negotiation, the parties or the representatives. Suppose the dispute is between the client and the contractor. So these two parties, or maybe some representative from the client and some representatives from the contractor side, they might come together into a certain hall. Like this is the place of discussion where these four people, let's just assume four people, two from the client side or two from the contractor side, they have come and they have met over the table. So this is a kind of conference or maybe a discussion, a very informal kind of discussion and very private discussion, and they just meet here to come to a consensus that okay, it was your fault, maybe the client would convince, maybe some adjustment would be made by the client here, some adjustment would be made by the contractor, and after coming out of this room they will say okay, finally we have settled. Okay, so this will not involve any third party person, just between the client people and the contractor people, they will themselves come to a final conclusion, some adjustment from either of the parties. Okay, so this is called as negotiation. Very simple process, just like a very normal process only. Okay, so it might involve some rounds of discussion also, like in one round the consensus might not have been reached, so they will call for second round also, might be possible in second also it won't reach. Then there can be involvement of third party, which will be discussing in arbitration, then mediation and conciliation. So what are the pros and cons of negotiation? The pro is that, very simple pro is, no third party involved. Okay, there is no involvement of third party, the matter remains just in between the two parties amongst which the dispute arose. Okay, next is, it is a very fast process, no involvement of any legal thing, so it will happen very fastly. If it is bound to happen, it will happen mostly in first or second round only. If it is not bound to happen, there is some ego in the client or maybe in the contractor side, definitely they will realize that there is no point of discussion, so mostly after first or second round it will get collapsed. Okay, and it will move to third party, maybe mediation or conciliation or maybe arbitration also. Then other thing is, I already told, no legal involvements, no legal entities are involved at all. Next is, very cheap. Why cheap? Because there is no third party person who is hired, so they will just discuss amongst themselves, there is no cost at all. Okay, then it maintains healthy relationship between the client and the contractor. Okay, because the matter is not escalated to someone else, because of which the relations might get ruined. What are the cons? It needs mutual willingness. See, this is very difficult actually, you know, because the dispute arose because they were not agreeing. So just by sitting in a hall and discussing in a very calm manner, I don't think so it will usually happen. So it needs mutual willingness, which is difficult. Until and unless some third party involves, they won't settle for a very big thing. No, it's a very small amount that is to be claimed, then it's okay. But for big things, they won't come to a mutual consensus at all. So another thing is multiple rounds. If the multiple rounds go, then it's a wastage of time. Okay, in case they don't come to a consensus in one round, they go for three rounds, four rounds, and the complete process gets delayed, and in case the work is also stopped at site, then it may further lead to extra expenses at the site level. Okay, so this is all about the negotiation. Now moving on to the second type of resolution method, which is mediation. Okay, now what happens in mediation? See, mediation is an alternate dispute resolution method. So it involves one mediator. This is a person who is a third party fellow, not from the client or contractor, and he is called as a mediator. Okay, now this particular person is usually chosen by the client and contractor both altogether, and this person, what he does is that he has to be paid first of all. So there will be some extra cost for hiring the mediator as compared to the negotiation. So there is one con associated with mediation, that it is a costly process as compared to the negotiation. So what happens is this person is a neutral person because he is neither from the client side nor from the contractor side. So what happens, this person is hired and he will meet the client and the contractor individually. He won't meet them in a common discussion room, but instead he will try to convince the client. He will just understand the matter from both the parties and he will try to convince them individually. He'll tell the client, okay, it's not his fault, let it be. Similarly, he will try to convince the contractor also. Maybe one person can come to one person might adjust, the client or the contractor, or both might adjust little, and there can be a consensus after the mediator tries to convince both of them. Okay, so this is what happens in the mediation process. They don't meet all together. It's just individual meeting with the mediator and the client, and mediator with the contractor. This is also called as brokered negotiation because they are involving one broker kind of person, no? Who helps in getting you flats and all, just like a broker in common language is called as a person who will just speed up the process and help you reach out to the owner and the customers. Okay, so next thing is that mediator will only advise or consult with them impartially with these two parties individually, and it will help both of them to reach to a consensus. He doesn't have any power to come to a conclusion. He can't tell them that they have to come to a conclusion. It might be possible that even after rounds of mediation, there is no conclusion at all. So he doesn't hold any legal authority. He can't come to a conclusion. He can't tell both of them that client is okay or contractor is okay. He is just an advisor kind of person. Okay. The next thing is that this is not at all legal until and unless they come to a conclusion and they sign an agreement. If the mediator is successful in convincing both of them, then what happens, the client and contractor will shake hand and they will mention that the claim is settled like this, and they will sign. Okay, both of them will sign, then it will become legal. But until and unless they come to a conclusion, the mediator cannot impose any legal thing on both of them. So it is not at all legal until and unless both of them come to a conclusion. Okay, so now discussing the pros and cons of mediation. Very simple pros. Again, the relationship will be healthy as compared to the court matters. If it's taken to the public forum, then it will just ruin the relationship. But as compared to negotiation, this will ruin a little bit of relationship because some third party person is involved. Then next is, it is quick as compared to litigation and all. Court matters, it is quicker. Then it is confidential. Okay, it is not taken to the public forum at all. No public is allowed to witness all this. Then it is cheaper than litigation. Okay, because litigation will involve hell lot of money. What are the cons? It is expensive than negotiation. Okay, then wastage of time in case no consensus is reached by the mediator. Okay, then the mediator can indulge in malpractice. Okay, why? Because he is meeting the people individually. So someone may try to corrupt him, or maybe someone may try to pull him towards his side by offering him some kind of money or something, or bribe or something. Okay, so they might involve in malpractices also, which is a very crucial cone of mediation. Now moving on to the third type of method of dispute resolution, which is nothing but your conciliation. Now this is nothing similar to mediation, just the fact is the person is called as conciliator and he will meet the client and the contractor all together. So they will meet in a single forum instead of meeting them individually, which happened in mediation process. In conciliation process, they will meet all together under a single roof. That is the only difference. Rest everything remains the same, that conciliator doesn't have any power, okay? Or similarly, the conciliator he cannot impose his decision, okay? And now, but one thing what is different is that conciliator, he can propose something in writing. He can tell that based on the complete conversation, this is my proposal to the client and the contractor, that the client was a bit wrong this side, or maybe the contractor was not right at this particular point. So he can write his decision, like write a proposal, not a decision. So it's up to the contractor and the client whether he agrees to the proposal that is given by the conciliator based on the discussion or no. But he cannot impose his decision at all. Okay, so this is all. This is it. Now, what are the pros and cons? The very first pro is that again it is faster as compared to arbitration and litigation. The next is communication is transparent, which was missing in the case of mediation. Is open and transparent because they are discussing everything here only. What are the cons? The outcome is not legally binding, so this is one con. If it would be legally binding, then definitely they would have come to a conclusion. So here again, time wastage can happen if they don't come to a conclusion. And again, there is no judicial power with the conciliator. So this is again a repeated kind of code. Okay. So now moving on to the next very important type of dispute resolution method, which is called as arbitration. Very important. Now see what happens in the case of arbitration. So this is the most commonly used method in construction, because these third parties and all which don't have any judicial powers, they can't influence any of them when the case is big and elevated already. So it is a most commonly method for which the contractors usually and clients usually go. Okay. Now what happens? The conflicting parties agree to submit dispute to one or more independent arbitrators. So there is one dispute review board which is selected, usually one person or maybe 3 person or 5 person. Why is it odd number? I'll just let you know. I'll just tell you, just wait for few seconds. So if there is one person, then it is chosen both by client and contractor altogether. If it's 3, then one person will be chosen by client, one person will be chosen by contractor, not from their own industry, their own company, but from a different, definitely from outside only, external person only, but he will choose. Then these together, they both will choose the third person. Okay. So this will form a committee. So this will be neutral committee more or less, because the third person, the client person chosen by client can favor the client, the contractor person chosen can favor the contractor, but this third person will not favor anyone. So that is why an odd number is kept, so that the tie condition does not arise. If this person favors client, this person favors contractor, if only 2 people are chosen, then it will be a tie. So as a tiebreaker, third person is chosen. So that is why the number is always kept as an odd number. Okay, so I hope, and this third person is also called as a brother arbitrator. Brother arbitrator. Okay, now see, again this is done privately only. Arbitration is a very private thing, but this is legally enforceable. What does it mean, legally enforceable? It means that whatever this committee, DRB committee, dispute resolution board committee, this committee will have the powers that whatever decision they will take, this will be legally enforceable, and after the discussion rounds, the client and contractor will have to agree to the decision put up by the dispute resolution board committee or the arbitration committee. Okay, so this is also called as a quasi-judicial method. Why quasi-judicial? Because it's not fully judicial, it's happening in private, but it's legally enforceable just like the court matters. So that is why quasi-judicial, not fully judicial. Okay, then here, just like the legal thing, whatever happens in the court, everyone can present their evidences, they can present their witnesses, examination of the witnesses can happen, site visits can happen by these people, they can also seek some external advices if they want, because they are not fully like into law, and also if they want to consult any experts, then they are all free to seek the consultants' advice also. So, and this particular complete process is it's governed by arbitration and conciliation act of 1996. Everything will happen under this particular law. This law will state the governance of this particular method. Okay, so what are the pros? Again, I'm just not writing, I'm just telling you that pros are that it will take less time as compared to litigation. Because what happens, the person who is chosen as arbitrator, they have certain less number of cases as compared to the person who will be chosen in the case of litigation. Instead, litigation, the people are not chosen, but they are the normal people, normal lawyers and all. So they have multiple cases for hearing. But in this case, these people who are chosen, they will be having very less number of cases as compared to the litigators. Okay. Second pro is that the time, place and date of the meeting are mutually decided by the parties, unlike in the case of litigation. Third thing is that it's a confidential process, unlike litigation. Next thing is it's more flexible as compared to the court proceedings, the date and all. It's very much flexible when you compare it with the court. But in court, if you have to come to this particular place at this point, you will have to come. Otherwise, your case will not be heard at all. Then the cons for this method will be that the parties have to bear the cost of the venue as well as the arbitrator. So this is a bit costly method as compared to mediation and conciliation and definitely negotiation. Then for the losing party has very less number of rights when he has to appeal once again. No, if the person who is the winning party, he is considered as a winner, then the losing party won't be in a position to raise any kind of claims further, because he is just declared as a losing party. That's it, he is just declared guilty. The next topic is litigation. The last method, but not the least, is litigation, which is again a kind of dispute resolution method. Okay, now what happens in this litigation method? No one chooses the panel, instead it's a panel of judges who are chosen by the proper usual government law methods and all. Okay, it's a public process, happens in the normal courts. Okay, it's legally binding, fully legally binding, just like the normal court hearings. No, what are the pros? That the judges are independent, so they are not at all chosen by anyone, so they cannot get influenced by anyone, and this is a decision oriented method. Ultimately, there will be a decision. Cons can be, it is a very, very, very expensive method, because it will involve hell lot number of rounds and whatnot. You'll have to pay a lot also. Then no confidentiality, because it's discussed in a public forum. Then it's a very, very slow process. N number of hearings can happen. Then relationships will get degraded like anything. And then another thing is, whenever you are into a litigation method, then your pre-qualification criteria that as a contractor you have to fulfill, no, then it will have a stamp of litigation on it forever. So this is least preferred in construction, that don't go for litigation, go for arbitration. So that is why I told that arbitration is the most common method and litigation is not at all preferred. It will ruin the position of the contractor and the client like anything, and the client and contractor won't be willing to get into a certain project or maybe a contract in the near future at all. So this is all about the dispute resolution methods. I hope I cleared the topic completely, but if you still have any doubts, because there is always a scope of doubts, then you can just raise your questions in the comment section. Also, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you are new here, because many more videos related to construction management will be coming very soon. Already many videos have already been posted. So thank you everyone, and all the very best for your career.